Hiya, I'm Jim Farey. I'm here in my teaching studio in Nottingham. And I've recently been playing with some samba bands, and one of the many issues that I've run into is when we talk about triplets or playing three notes. And I just want to do a really simple thing for anyone who does a bit of world percussion, or you know, is a part-time percussionist, don't want to do it as a job or a professional, just want to have a bit more of an understanding about when people talk about triplets or groups of three notes, because they're slightly different things. So I'm just going to play on my pad, on my snare drum. And first of all, I'm just going to put my metronome on, and I'm going to play. I'm going to play some groups of four. Okay, these could be called semiquavers, or they could be called 16th notes. I'm going to play four sounds on the pad for every click on the metronome. I'm going to slow that down to 60. And just today, I'm going to count like this. The high note is one, one, one. Okay, so subdivide like this. One, two, three, four, 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 one, two, three, four. Okay, so that was easy. I hope that was easy. If it wasn't easy, just do it again. I was playing right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. So the right hand was always on the beat, but you can play the other way. This is at 60 beats a minute. I'm now going to play, I'm now going to play triplets, okay? So instead of breaking the beat up into four even parts, I'm going to break it up into three even parts, okay? So we could call these quaver triplets, okay? Or we could call them eighth note triplets. It's the same thing, just depends on where you are in the world normally, okay? So I'll count these just for today. I'll find the one. One is the high note. One. And then I'll count three evenly. One, two, three, 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 Okay, so that was quite easy. On some metronomes, there will be a function where you can subdivide the beat. Okay, you can press a button and you'll see a graphic on the screen. One will be a group normally of four 16th note semiquavers, and then one will be a group of three quaver triplets with a little three numeral over the top. quaver triplets are the same as eighth note triplets. So I'll just show you 60 BPM with the metronome subdividing. So I'm going to press. So here is semi-quavers. One, two, three, four. 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 So there, the high note is the beat, and the low notes are all the subdivisions, and the metronome is dividing each beat into four for me. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. I could play with it. Okay, and I can also ask my metronome to divide into triplets for me. Here goes that. The high note is the beat, and the low notes are the subdivision. One, two, three, one, two, three. Still, all of this has been at 60 beats a minute. One, two, three, 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 four. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. Okay, so that's all relatively simple. Okay, if you've got any questions at this point, then you should go back to the beginning of the video and just have another look, another listen. Okay, try and play along with it, play each exercise for a reasonable amount of time. Okay, so that's groups of four even notes spread over a beat and groups of three even notes spread over a beat. Okay, 16th notes or semiquavers. Eighth note triplets or quaver triplets. Okay, now this is where people start to come a little bit unstuck, because sometimes we want to play a group of three notes. Okay, and what's happening normally in a lot of the rhythms that I'm hearing with some of the samba stuff and some of the world music is people are trying to play as if there were four subdivisions. Okay, so like one, two, three, four. And they only want to play the first three notes. So it's like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay, so I'm missing out the four each time. And those notes are not all the same length. The first two are quick, and the last one is slow. Or you could say that the first two are short, and the last one is long. Short, short, long. Short, short, long. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay? What I'm not doing is this. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. When I do that, each note is part of a triplet. Okay, so I'm now going to put my metronome on, and I'm going to play. First of all, I'm going to ask the metronome to subdivide all four notes for me, 16th notes or semiquavers, and I'm going to play the first three notes, and I'm not going to play anything on four. Sometimes I'll count, sometimes I won't. The key to this for me when I was learning was to count. If you don't count and you don't have a really good understanding of this at slow tempos, you know, you can go right down to 40 beats a minute, then you may remain stuck on this for a long time. So it's worth counting and worth going slow. So here goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I'm now going to try that exactly the same tempo, 60 BPM, but I'm going to ask the metronome to simply beep on each beat for me. Okay, so I will do all the subdividing myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, go back and compare that to triplets, okay, now I'm going to play triplets where every note is an equal third of the beat. So I'm going to set myself up by feeling it differently. One, two, three, 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 one. Okay, so now I'm going to go around that, and I'm going to play. I'm going to play a group of three. So one, two, three, and a nothing on the fourth semiquaver or 16th note. Okay, I'm just going to say four, either out loud or in my head. One, two, three. One, two, three, and then I'm going to do four bars. Okay, that's 16 beats, four bars of quaver triplets or eighth note triplets. So they'll be evenly spaced out and it will hopefully feel more even. So four bars of groups of three, four bars of triplets. And then I'm going to go around that a few times. Try and join in. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, four, 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 one, two, three, four. Okay, so if you're a drummer and you play a drum kit like this, then you may want to put some feet underneath that. If you are in a samba band or a marching band, then you're definitely going to need to learn to step underneath that. So the first thing I would do with that is I would learn to play right, left, right, left on the feet. Okay, so that's like walking or marching. Okay, and this is very fundamental. I was taught this by my first teacher in my first lesson, so it's quite a useful thing to know. Okay, and I'm going to play. Yeah, I'm going to play the drum and the hi-hat cymbal. Okay, the bass drum and the hi-hat. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so let's try that. I'm going to mix up playing the groups of three and the triplets. Okay, so that was just doing some bars of three notes together. Go 1, 2, 3, rest on 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and some evenly spaced triplets. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then mixing them up. Another thing that you might like to consider doing is 2 right feet, 2 left feet. Okay? If you are playing in the samba band and you want to try and somehow interpret what's going on in the dancing into a sound, rather than going right, right, left, left, okay, because of the way that most of the samba bands that I've played with step, they tend to go right, left, left, right. Okay, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that was going from playing 16th notes, semiquavers, which is where I play 4 notes within each beat, and then I went to playing only the first 3 of those, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I went to playing even triplets, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. If you find it difficult, if you find it difficult to count at these speeds, just slow it down, you know, until you feel comfortable with your own voice. And then you can add in the feet if you wish, or you can just tap your feet, you know, or maybe you can dance, you know. On a pad or on a drum set, you can just tap away on your legs. Just want to add for anyone who's confused about when I'm playing the groups of three, why I play right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left, right. It's because I'm imagining, and you'll find that most people do this, I think, I'm imagining that I'm playing right, left, right, left, right, left, right, four, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, four, right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left, right. Okay? And then we just take out that left hand. So when a sticking pattern sequence of lefts and rights seems obscure, it's probably come from this idea of playing hand to hand, one then the other, and then just taking notes out. And you can actually achieve many different rhythms that way. Okay, so as well as playing the first three notes out of four, you could experiment with playing the first, the second, and the fourth note. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. That's going to give you two lefts. You could play the second, third, and the fourth note. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. You could miss out the second note, which will give you one, two, three, four. 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 Okay? And always the beat is where you say one, okay, and you can put your feet in there, okay. So when you do the alternate or the alternating feet and you miss out the first count, you get this interesting pattern where you get bass drum, three hands, hi-hat, three hands, foot, three hands, foot, three hands. Okay, so it's really important that you can miss out notes, control whether you play or don't play, and you know, to be able to put one of the feet on the beat, every beat, you know, the other foot maybe, alternating, leading with either the right or the left foot, and also playing two on the right, two on the left. You know, you could start anywhere. You can play right, right, left, left. You can play right, left, left, right. You can play left, left, right, right. Or you can play left, right, right, left. You're still playing doubles across the feet, but you just start in a different place and they all have their own flavour, if you like. Okay, and hopefully that's helped you to understand the difference between playing a group of three notes where there could have been four and evenly chopping up a beat into three notes, creating a triplet where there isn't any more space because you've broken the cycle within the beat into one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Okay, any questions, drop it on the comments and I'll try and reply as quickly as possible, or you can email me, but comments are good because other people can get the feedback. If you want my book, it's here. Myself and Paul Hose wrote this. It's called Drum Set for Beginners. It does contain things about rhythm and coordination as well as just playing drum set. It's available for Alfred, or you can buy it from myself or Paul or from drumsetforbeginners.com. So thanks for watching. I hope that's been helpful, and if you have any questions, fire away. Thanks.